daughters. You'll be put ashore on the safekeeping of these men. A ship is no place for a woman in time of battle.
I want to talk to him.
I'm sorry, the captain's busy.
Up anchor! Move! Hand the captain's bar! Let go! Get the sail on her! Thomas! Get those men!
Can I handle it, Jeremy?
Aye, aye, Peter.
We sail! Hard to stop!
Up that rigging, you monkeys! Aloft! There's no chains to hold you now! Break out those sails and watch them fill with the wind that's carrying us all to freedom!
We, the undersigned, are men without a country. Outlaws in our own land and homeless outcasts in any other. Desperate men, we go to seek a desperate fortune.
Therefore, we do here and now band ourselves into a brotherhood of buccaneers.
Me and my friends, we had a dream once. That life was going to be a great adventure. And we were going to be the heroes. We had a club. The Rogues. We used to hang out, playing ball, chasing after all the girls, and making plans, big plans. See, we were going to be like the guys in the movies. They were cool, they had all the moves. They were always getting the girl in the end. We couldn't wait to be just like them. And why not? After all, we were young enough. We had time enough to make our dreams come true. God knows we were dreamers. Everybody was going to be somebody. Me, I was going to be a great writer. My best friend Saul, he was going to conquer the world and take us all with him. And that was a long time ago. Some things change. Some things stay the same. Saul, he's still a dreamer. He still believes in happy endings. As for the rest of us, we still hang out together. Play football on Sundays in the park and make plans, big plans. But lately, something Saul said a long time ago has begun to haunt me. He used to say that we were shipwrecked on the north side of Chicago. And then if we didn't bust out soon, we'd get stuck here forever.
Hi, Daddy.
Well, Michael, hey, how you doing? Good time?
I heard.
I want you to meet my fiance.
Hi.
How are you doing? Good time?
Yeah, fine.
Furnace this place.
It looks great.
Billy, lunch next week. I'll give you a call, huh?
Yeah.
Danny boy! It's me. What are you doing? You're supposed to be here working on. What? What you got there?
Why?
There.
She's been hanging around for about an hour. You ask me, I think she's still crazy about you.
Hey, Wes, you.
Hey, don't get tough with me, Danny. I know what's going on.
So did you meet her?
Yeah.
What's his name?
Michael. He's okay. He owns 11 furniture stores. But he ain't one of us. You know what I mean? There ain't nobody like us. Nobody. Right?
How's Saul doing?
I feel like a chooch, man. I've been over there all week. I've been so busy. This place, I've been going crazy. Nick.
He understands.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry.
So what do you think of this joint, huh?
Looking great.
Yeah, this is quite some place here, Nathan. We really did it.
You wouldn't believe the VIPs that turned out tonight. Pete's here with his TV crew. I think this place is really gonna happen. What do you think?
Yeah.
All right. We got a clubhouse again.
Hey, Sal, we're on TV.
Oh, I hope not.
Well, here we are. What's left of the once mighty Rogues? Do you know what the girls used to say about us?
Mm-hmm.
They used to say, the Rogues, they're unstoppable.
Unstoppable? You must be talking about somebody else, because it's been a long time since I felt unstoppable. You see, I always wanted to be a writer, a storyteller. But it's always been a struggle. I've been ready to quit 1,000 times. Probably would have given it up a long time ago if it hadn't been for two people who have continued to believe in me. My best friend, Sal, who's in the hospital, dying. And my girlfriend, Emily, who's getting married on Sunday. Some other guy. Emily. I remember the first time I saw her.
Hey there, Mr. Mailman. I'm Rubens. I'm new. 57,
36.
36, yeah, right.
I'm Morgan. Different neighborhood of West Rogers Park.
Oh, isn't that where all the tough guys are from?
Well, not so tough.
Oh, no, I didn't think so. Do all mailmen have such cute legs?
Cute?
Yeah.
These are not cute legs.
Oh, no? Then what are they?
They're tough, rugged. Get the job done. Look at this scar.
Oh, that's very rugged. So, what have you got for me today? Anything interesting? Or are you just like all the rest with bills and advertisements?
Yeah, well, what do you want?
I want postcards, letters. Nobody writes letters anymore.
Your occupant, you can save $1.29 on a case of Coca-Cola.
Oh, you're funny. Funny guy.
What, do you think I'm funny?
Yeah. You should write some of this stuff down.
Well, I do. I'm a writer.
I thought you were a mailman.
Yeah, well, poor writers pay the rent by being mailmen. And cab drivers and fortune tellers and bartenders.
Oh. Fortune tellers?
Yeah.
You want to read my fortune?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. All right, here we go. This is very interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead, tell me. What do you see?
All right, here. It's going to rain on your wedding day.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
And what's the weather going to be like on your wedding day?
Ah, well, I don't know, because you can't tell your own fortune.
Oh, I see. Well, then let me tell for you.
All
right. Okay. Oh, there you are. Right there. Modern man. Face to face with himself. A little lost. A little lonely.
In a big hurry.
He's lost his heart and romance is dead.
Excuse me. You sure that's me?
Yeah. Yeah, all you guys. What happened to courtship? Oh, please, dear God, there's got to be some old-fashioned men out there. Some people who want to take their time. Eat a little ice cream. Watch the Late Late Show.
Yeah, excuse me, waiter, can we have some ice cream here, please? And a TV set. This girl to go.
Oh.
I was jumped by three Arabs.
In Morocco.
Then you know the kind of guy I am.
You're unstoppable.
You should have met me in my prime.
I never like guys in their prime. They're always too cocky.
You want to know something?
What?
I've never actually been to the Morocco. But I got plans. I got big plans. Hey, Danny! What are you doing?
Welcome home.
All right, buddy.
Looking good. Looking good.
He's adorable. He's gorgeous.
Welcome home, buddy.
All right, you guys. You want to know the truth? Here it is. We're in trouble. We're running out of time here.
I mean, 3-7 would be embarrassing. Come on.
But 0-10? We've never been 0-10. 0-10 is un-American. 0-10 is...
Listen, we're not 0-10 yet.
That's what's going to happen on Sunday.
Have you seen these guys? They call themselves the Animals. 9 feet tall.
Yeah, what happened to my boys? Who's responsible for this? Is it you, Scamoli? I heard you wore penny loafers to a game.
Hey! How many games have you missed?
Precisely. You guys are nothing without me. You got no one to strike fear into the hearts of the other guys. But don't worry. Help is on the way. I'm back. I'm playing some.
They made you back.
I mean, I'm feeling good. They got me on this new medicine.
What new medicine?
I don't know. It's new. I'm like a guinea pig. They don't know for sure what the hell it does, except they gave it to some guy in Seattle, and his hair started falling out, and he started twitching and saying things that nobody understood. But he came out of it, bigger and stronger than before. He's back at work. He was sicker than me, and he beat it.
He's sick like you, and he beat it.
Yeah. Can you believe it?
Yeah, I believe it. That's great.
Yeah, that's great.
Okay.
I think we're gonna win Sunday. I really do.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We gotta rally, Rogues. Yeah. We gotta rally!
All right,
we gotta beat those guys!
No,
big deal!
Give us a
game
plan.
A game plan?
Yeah.
Lob smarter. Right. We'll pretend we're huddling, and we'll set a man down.
Yeah.
I'm late for work.
So am I.
I can't be late for work again.
Neither can I.
Start starting to like you.
You are?
Yeah. A lot. Real lot.
Yeah. That's what every guy says to every girl.
Mm-mm. It's different.
What's different?
I'm different. We're different. This is different.
Every guy says to every girl.
Give her a call.
No.
Is it going to kill you?
It might.
Call her.
No.
What have you got to lose?
No, because what am I supposed to say? You know, what? Hello. I know it's a little late. I know you're getting married on Sunday, and suddenly I realized I can't live without you.
Great. That's great. You tell her that, and you'll sweep her right off.
Look, I don't know. I can't live without her. I couldn't live with her. I don't know what the hell to do. I feel like calling time out.
It's Emily. Talk to her. Tell her you want to see her. Hurry up. Tell her you want to see her tonight. And don't tell her I'm here. Don't tell her it was my idea.
It is too late.
What? What's too late? It's never too late. Dustin Hoffman would not have let her get away. I mean, he ran to that church and was pounding on the glass. Elaine. Benjamin. I mean, he was great.
Come on, Saul.
Oh, come on yourself, Danny. You want something, you go get it. It's as simple as that. Call her. Men have got to be bolder, more dashing. We should have been pirates. We could have been great pirates. You and me. We could have been the kind of guys they write about in books.
Danny, life is just speeding by like a jet plane.
You know this is no good.
There's probably just enough time to do everything. We just knew what we wanted.
This is really no good.
I mean, when I was 13, I knew what I wanted. I wanted to be a ballet dancer, but then I fell in love with Artie Mankiso.
This is
Artie Mankiso.
I wanted to be a rock and roll star.
I should have gone to ballet class. Try to save the whales.
Boxer.
Think about the poor whales. Dan.
Think about boxers. One
fight.
The world
is getting dirtier and dirtier and more dangerous.
One big
and everybody's having babies. So what's the big deal about babies? Just tell me that.
You're rich for the rest of your life.
You get all stretched out. You can't go anywhere. You can't do anything. And you worry about them all the time.
I can't handle this.
Then they grow up. They move out. And maybe they call you on Mother's Day. So what's the big deal? I mean, I'm still young and alive. I'm feeling very alive these days. I want to be challenged. I want to surprise myself. I want to go looking for the truth. I want to fight the good fight. I want to beat the bad guys. And I want to win the game.
What the hell are you talking about?
Oh, well. I think we should get married and have a family. Say yes.
Married?
Forget it. God, I can't believe I'm doing this. I'm Emily Reyes. I don't go around trying to talk to
you. Wait, Emily!
This is embarrassing.
Hey, come here.
No.
Here.
No.
Come here.
Don't make me.
Come here.
What?
You know, for a smart girl, you really don't understand men.
Well, then teach me. I want to learn.
All right, men are different from women.
Know that.
No, you don't know that. Men are different from women. Men have to get their lives together before they can think about making other plans. I mean, look at my life. Except for you. It's a total mess.
It's not a mess.
It's
total just a little messy, and I could
mess.
Help you with that, Danny.
M.
I'm very good at helping.
M.
What?
You're supposed to let the man ask.
Great.
All right. As soon as I finish the book.
The book?
Yeah.
Well, you haven't started writing.
Yes, I have three chapters.
You do?
Yeah. Well, I have an idea.
What's it about?
Well, it's about a lot of things. It's about a guy like me. It's about a girl like you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, all right. We're making progress.
We are?
Yeah.
No, wait, what did I just say?
What you said was that you were going to write a book, and then we were going to get married.
That's what I said?
That's what I heard.
Write a book.
Yes.
And we're gonna get married?
Yeah.
What? This is a tuna fish sandwich. And dogs don't like tuna fish.
Thank you, Mr. Jones.
My pleasure, sir.
What is this?
I don't know.
I know how you feel. I've been down in the dumps myself. Then I got into fashion. How do I look?
Where'd you get that outfit?
For $1,000, I got the clothes, the car, and Mr. Jones for the whole day. Are you ready?
What are we doing?
What are we doing today, Mr. Jones?
We're going to rally.
Ready? The Barzini sisters have been delivering singing telegrams since last Christmas when...
What?
Oh, no. Oh, no. No way. I'm right in the middle of a story. I'm not gonna... Come on!
Come on. Come on.
Well, look. I gotta be back by 6.
Come on. Come on. Yeah!
Okay. My old lady ran away with my brother-in-law. My girlfriend is
what
pregnant.
What is this?
Someone stole my
film,
my fuzzy
dice. Here.
You know
I
that?
I don't care about your fuzzy
dice. Hey, man, listen. You know what you are? You're hyper. You know
hyper.
That? You
hyper.
Are hyper.
Hyper.
That's right, man. You're hyper.
No, no, I can't leave these animals. No, no way. No.
No, 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 no.
I'm Mickey.
We know.
Hi, excuse me.
Yes,
hi.
Miss, I grew up with these guys. This is a joke. They're practical jokers.
Are you really writing about Marty for Fortune magazine?
Come on, I'll tell you all about Marty. It'll be great.
Trust
yeah.
us.
So I did. I bought a train load of hog belly. A whole goddamn train load of them little porkers.
What did you do?
Yeah, wait, what does that mean? Ah, what does that mean? That means that if hog belly's open high Monday morning, I'm a millionaire.
All right, I'm in!
What happens if they open lower? What happens if they open lower? You mean... Yeah. Lower. Then I go to jail.
All right, Eddie! Hey! Hey! Woo, woo.
Hey,
you don't worry about it. I'll tell you something else. I am going to win!
I can't. It's late, and we just got the kids in bed, and...
Well, what do you want me to do? Just
walk back in there and say, hey, hey, Linda, I'm out of here. No, 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 I can't. I can't. I don't know what's happening to me. I mean, there I was, driving home up Sheridan Road through Evanston, past the university, just like I've done 1,000 times. Only this time, I stop, get out, walk around, and I start thinking, God damn, I want to be a sophomore in college again.
You want to be a sophomore in college again?
Yeah, I do.
Boom. You're a sophomore in college again.
Hey!
It is very important.
Eddie.
My name is Eddie Holman.
Ed.
I'm his client. Will you please try and reach him or
Eddie.
Something? Mickey, will you please try and understand that I am trying to call my attorney?
Shake it off.
Where are we going?
Hurry up.
Please.
We've got to hurry. Follow me. Have no fear.
Counting on you. Be real.
Watch it.
Oh. Okay. All right.
The place.
We're here.
Oh, man. Are we here yet? Really?
Mickey, no peeking.
Yes, maestro. Whatever you say.
Okay. Open your eyes. Too late to become pirates, Marty?
Yeah. It's too late, so.
What do you think, Mr. Jones?
I think it's never too late.
I agree.
Are you with me, boys?
Oh! Hail the torpedo!
I've just begun to fight!
Where are we going?
We're going to Tortuga!
What's that?
That's the place where dreams come true.
Full speed ahead!
We can do it! They can't stop us now!
Row, boys! Row your hearts out.
What do you do with a drunken sailor?
What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning.
Lock him up with the captain's daughter.
Lock him up with the captain's daughter. Lock him up with the captain's daughter.
Put him in the longboat till he's sober. Early in morning.
You okay?
I don't know.
Guess he's got to take it easy. We got a little carried away. Shouldn't be drinking so much with the new medicine. Shouldn't be drinking so much, right? What? What'd I say?
Oh, Mick. There's no new medicine.
What about the guy from Seattle?
There's no guy from Seattle. Just a little game we've been playing. You knew that. You've always known that, haven't you? Yeah, I knew that. I guess I knew that.
What should we do?
I gotta get home.
Yeah, me too. I'll try and get back later.
What a night, huh? It's been a long time since we ran one out like that.
Yeah. We had a good time. Didn't we, Mr. Jones?
Yes, we did. We had a good time. A very good time.
I'm gonna shave my mustache off.
I like your mustache.
Go for a walk. I mean, there's a carnival in the park. Saul says there's a guy who eats fire.
Thought you wanted to work. You haven't worked in weeks.
I have nothing to say.
Oh, yes, you do.
I have nothing to say.
Danny, what are you talking about?
Do you know what I do all day while you're working? You know what I do? I go to, like, the library or the bookstores, and I open books. Right? And I open the book, and I read this, and I say, you know, like, this is writing.
You can
no, this
write
is
like
writing. This.
This
is a writer. I am not a writer.
You can't
I am
be
not
a writer.
A writer.
You could be such
I am
a
kidding
good
myself,
writer.
And I am kidding you. How do you know that?
I know. Oh, I know because I live with you.
You? What does that mean? You live with me. What does that mean?
It means that you should write the way that you talk. Do you know that you're always telling me the greatest stories about you and your friends and Saul and your adventures and all those things? You should write that down on paper because that's the stuff you know about.
All right. Danny goes to work. Want to see me work? Right? Picture Danny writing. Right? Danny writes. Paper, pencil. Danny writes. Danny is a writer. Danny... feel like writing. I don't.
Danny, the world needs storytellers.
All right.
The world needs to be inspired.
All right. I got the point.
Don't you understand? It's not just writers.
You just lay off it, because you get on something, you just never let go.
Okay, I'm off it. I am off it. I am really off it.
What? Look, they don't allow dogs in this building. okay? Look. I got enough trouble taking care of myself. I'm sorry.
Actually, I came home, and there he was, poor guy, and so I brought him to you.
Danny. Danny.
Huh?
He's too old and too big. Nobody's gonna take him home.
Wait, don't.
This is not the city pound. It's an overcrowded animal shelter. Not a, a hotel for dinosaurs.
Hey, wait. This is not a dinosaur, right? This is a very special dog. This is a talking dog.
A talking dog.
Well, actually, it's more like a singing dog. I heard him singing last night. He sounds a lot like Frank Sinatra. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead, sing it, too. Sing it. Sing your guitar.
Fairy tales can come true.
Danny.
What can happen to you if you're young at heart?
Bring him in. Oh. So you got a haircut?
Yeah. It's getting a little long.
I liked it long. Made you look like Beethoven.
Well, I hear it's supposed to rain tomorrow.
A fortune teller once told me that it was going to rain on my wedding day.
So you're getting married?
Yeah.
You're really getting married?
Yeah.
Now, does that mean that we won't be dating anymore?
No. No, I'll still be dating.
Good. That's good, because I wanted to ask you to the big Halloween party tonight.
Oh, sorry. You're too late. I've already got a date.
Oh. Well, come anyway. Bring him too. The more the merrier.
What do you want to say, Danny? You can say anything you want to me.
I just want to say that
I'll miss you. I'll miss talking to you. We had some great talks, didn't we?
We had the best talks. The best. You taught me a lot. A real lot.
So did you. Wow. Sounds like we were a great couple.
Oh, we were. Just wasn't our time, I guess.
Yeah, was that it?
I don't know, Danny. We tried so hard. Maybe we tried too hard. Maybe we should have known that if we were really right for each other, then we wouldn't have been trying so hard to be right for each other. Who knows? Maybe we should have tried harder. Oh, I don't know, Danny. Of course, you were a fool to let a girl like me get away.
She'll be there.
Yeah. How do you know?
I know women, and Emily is a woman. She'll be there, and she'll look beautiful.
This is crazy. I can't.
It's not crazy. It's bold.
Yeah, is it too bold?
No, it's not bold enough. As soon as she walks into that party, you gotta get her alone somehow and tell her you blew it. You fucked up.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes!
No, I gotta do this right. You know, Emily, it's all about the ebb and flow of things and a look across the room and the gesture of subtlety.
Oh, come on. You don't have time for subtlety. You gotta walk up to her and tell her you love her. You really love her, and then she shouldn't marry that guy. Oh, for Christ's sakes. He's from Milwaukee.
Sakes, what are we doing? Why are you consoling me? I should be consoling you.
All right, console me. Give me a pep talk.
You want a pep talk? I'll give you a pep talk.
I'm ready. Oh, a little more passion, a little more fire.
What am I going to do without you?
You'll come alive, like Mount St. Helens. Boom. What do you mean, no?
I mean, no. How can you be dying?
Oh, it's the easiest thing I ever did. And the white blood cells are...
No, don't joke!
What? What do you want me to do? You want me to sit around crying? What do you think I do when you're not here? You think I sit around making jokes? No, I sit around here wondering, how can this be happening to me? This can't be happening to me. I was going to be Alexander the Great, right? Not some salesman dying in a hospital. I don't want to die in a hospital. It's so unromantic. Unheroic. Don't listen to me. I'm just feeling sorry for myself. Wait a second. This is a great hospital. They got these beds. Look at that. What more could a guy want, right?
It wasn't so much the dying as it was dying in the hospital. I just
And I looked at him and I thought, maybe if we all pitched in, we could get a boat. We could sail off. Just like he always wanted to do. All of us. We make Saul happy. Make him happy at the end.
I don't know, Danny. We had a... Hey, here he is. Littlest quarterback in America here. Get up here. We had a good time last night. We had fun. And Saul had fun. I gotta tell you something. When I'm holding this kid in my arms, it's better than all the good times. You know what I mean?
No, 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 please. He had one dream his whole life.
Okay.
Hey, now, why shouldn't that come true?
No.
Because that's life.
Danny. Danny, some dreams just don't come true. I was going to save the world. And you were going to be a great writer. And look at us, Danny. Look at us. Look at what we're doing. I mean, I'm covering restaurant openings. You would. What are you doing?
Danny, I don't like boats. I can't swim. I get seasick. Just... You think I'm being a bad guy? You know I'm not a bad guy.
I know.
I can't just take off like that. I got investors that I'm responsible to. I got 45 tables out there. I got a bunch of food on.
I know.
Waiters and all that. I know.
I got
a bunch of inexperienced
tables. Here I go again, because what am I supposed to do? Sit around the hospital all day and hold his hands?
Yeah, that's right. That's all you can do is hold his hand.
I
that's
don't
all
know. I don't believe that. That's not enough. That. We gotta do something.
You want me to do something?
Yeah.
I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna make him some soup. I'm gonna make him some soup, and I'm gonna hold his hand. That's what I do. I make soup, and I hold hands.
Well, why not? What, are you so busy?
Yes, I am so busy. But that's not it.
Well, what is it? Will you tell me,
yes,
please?
Yes, you want me to tell you?
Yeah.
All right, then I'll tell you. I mean, seeing Saul get sicker and sicker. I can't. I just can't watch him die anymore. I don't want to be there at the end. I want to remember him just the way he was. I'm sorry, Danny. But I think that you've done everything that you can do for Saul. And now, I think you should start thinking about your own life.
Be hanging. want you to meet somebody. Sherry, this is my best friend, Danny.
Hi, Sherry.
So. Yeah. You want another one?
Why don't I get you?
Yeah, that'd be great. I'll have a,
Who is that?
Well, I figure since I'm probably going to jail on Monday, I deserved a good time.
Sure.
I made a few phone calls, and the next thing I knew, I had a date with Sherry, the most expensive woman in the world.
She's a hooker?
For $2,000 a night, you don't call them hookers. No, you call them, ladies of the night. She's amazing. Oh, God, she's so good. She is so good. She's amazing. She's good. Sometimes I think she even likes me. Dan, wouldn't it be amazing if in the morning I give her the money, she looks at it, she smiles lovingly, and then she just kind of pushes it back my way. And she says, keep it. I can't take any money from you. Too good a time.
Hey, how you doing?
Listen, I'm sorry I didn't have more time to talk to you at the club the other night. I had so many people to deal with, I thought I was gonna go crazy.
Was it like a goodbye kiss or a hello kiss?
I don't know.
You mean she kissed you like maybe she's still...
I don't know.
Oh, boy. Oh, we're in trouble. Hell, we're running out of time here. We're gonna pull this one off, right?
Right.
Okay. Glad you're here. Sometimes I get a little scared. Do you think there's really a heaven? We spent all that money getting to the moon. We should have spent it trying to get to heaven. I know the moon's out there. All I have to do is look up and see it. But heaven. What about heaven? I mean, I was reading this book about dying. And it talked about the soul. How the soul never dies. Do you believe in the soul?
Yeah. See, the way I figure it is you're just going on ahead of me. You're like a scout.
Great. Why do I always get the good jobs? All right. I'll make you a promise. If there is some place after all this, a heaven or something, I'll get word back to you somehow. Okay?
Okay, but don't be shy. And just stop by one night. I'll be glad to see you.
I don't know. I'll probably scare the shit out of you.
All right, well, let's have a sign. Like a bird outside my window, or a wind.
Yeah. Maybe I'll blow your hat off one afternoon.
Yeah. Chicago's a windy city. All I know, it's you.
You'll know. Her on the lips. I knew it. You sly dog, you. I knew it.
Sunday! Sunday! Sunday!
racing capital of Mid-America. Be there or be square. Highlighting the funny cars of the four-wheel drive world. Plus, big
we got to go.
Yeah, I know.
Where you going?
We're late for church.
Church?
Yeah, you want to come?
It's going to be the duel of the century. Thundering, flat-out touch-taking
Well, I guess this is it, huh? This is strange. Hold on. Okay, so I have this, and I wasn't sure if I was supposed to tip you or not. Odd. So I included a tip.
Thanks.
Thank you. You were wonderful. Really wonderful.
Hi, Danny.
Just happened to be in the neighborhood. Thought I'd stop by and see what you're up to.
I'm just drying my hair. Getting married.
Yeah. Look, can I talk to you for a minute?
We're making a mistake. Are we going to regret this? No. We're going to see each other in 10 years and wonder, maybe it should have been you and me. Kids and everybody. Probably the last game for the old gang. Nobody
says it, we don't know it. We haven't won a game all year. Maybe today. We can put it all together, you know? One more time. I wish you'd come by. I mean, it didn't rain. It was supposed to rain. Oh, Em, what are you doing? It's you and me. You know that, don't you? Don't marry this guy. Marry me. I'm the guy for you.
Oh, Danny. No. Don't. Please don't. We should go.
Want me to go? Is that what you want?
Today, maybe? Hey.
What about Sal?
Huh?
What are we gonna do about Sal?
Look. After this, we go up to the hospital. We bring in the game ball. And we cheer him up.
We'll bring him a case of Lohenbrock.
Here's the good friend.
Danny.
Tonight is gonna...
No, well, I've been a damn beer commercial.
The guy's lying there alone and he's scared.
I got him!
And I don't understand why I have to try to talk you guys into this.
Danny, please, we're in the middle of a goddamn football game.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Come on.
All right, let's do it. Let's try a little fair pass, right?
Yeah, you think you'd have to ask...
You don't...
You think you'd have to ask Saul to do something for us?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah,
no!
Yeah.
No way! Because you never had to ask Saul. He was always there. All right, fine. What? Flare pass up the middle.
Right, cool. Danny, right. You can't throw a flare pass up the middle.
Okay.
On what?
On
Mississippi. Let's make it work. Let's go.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh. 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 Hey, I got him! Oh.
When you opened up your first restaurant, over on Belmont, who rounded up the customers, right? Who spent a week rounding up the customers? Not me, not Eddie, it was Saul.
All right, we're gonna go. We're gonna go with the old Alabama.
I got him, come on!
I got him! Go. Danny! Hey!
One more thing. When you were when you were gonna get fired from the station, right? You started the write-in campaign, right? 1,000 letters mailed from all over the city, right? Nobody bothered checking the type. It was all the same type.
Sick!
That was Saul?
Yeah, of course it was Saul.
I got him!
Get it out of my face, will you?
Danny, shut up! You wanted to buy your first duplex, yeah. Right? That dump?
Yeah.
Right? You needed $5,000 to fix it up?
Who gave you the money? Who gave
Saul.
You the money?
Saul, that's right. Not me, not Danny. Pete, not Bobby. Danny. It was Saul. In fact, he had to steal it from his mother.
And I paid him back.
No, you didn't pay him back. You could never pay him
Danny,
back.
Danny, Danny will you let it go? Will you let it go?
Pay him.
Look at the
pay
score.
Pay him back, Marty?
Come on,
none of us could.
Time. Let's go,
huh? It's gonna rain.
None of us could pay him back.
Ready?
What the fuck is this?
Set one. Set two. Set three.
Hey.
Great.
Hey. Marty. What do you want me to do? You want me to kiss your ass? You want me to kiss your ass? I'll kiss your ass.
You know, when we were growing up, I used to think we were forever. Nothing was more important than us guys. That was a long time ago. Now, almost everything seems more important. Girlfriends, bank accounts, vanity, everything.
Maybe that's the way it should be, Danny. It's called growing up.
Yeah, maybe so, Marty, but I always expected more of us. I always expected the Rogues to rally.
Okay. Let's take our last shot here. Everybody go long.
Sorry, gonna be up for a half hour.
Hey!
couple, the new Mr. and Mrs. Michael Forbes. And now we'd like them to come out and start the first dance.
Who's there?
This is Bull Martin. Captain Bull Martin. Ready?
Where are we going?
Tortuga.
What are you doing?
Just trust me, okay? Okay?
I mean, you're kidding, right?
Come on. Come on.
Are you just talking, or are you really talking?
Want these?
You mean we're really...
Every yard of canvas she'll take, you monkeys!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Set sail for freedom!
I've been wanting to get away for years. You know, kick back, do a little fishing,
Well, don't be standing around. Get aloft!
Yes! Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes.
You bastard.
You guys need a cook?
Hey!
All right.
Yeah. Hey. Salami, pickles, mustard, potato chips.
This is great. We can fart our way all the way to China.
All right!
Well, you didn't think I was gonna stay home all by myself, did you?
I got these pills for seasickness, shark repellent, a flare gun, and all the rest of this stuff from my attorney here. Who recommended I leave town for about 75 years. Hi, guys.
Eddie.
Hi, Eddie.
Let's go. Let's go.
All right.
Hey, Saul. It's great to be here. I'm still in trouble, but I still may win.
Yay!
All right. Yay!
Uh-oh.
Oh, whoa, whoa!
I was lounging on the veranda this morning, remembering something Saul once told me. He said, Mickey, my boy, Tahitian women are the greatest. Which raises the most important question of the day. Which way is Tahiti?
That way!
Thanks.
For what?
For everything.
Saul died at sundown on the ninth day. Sitting around on deck, telling stories, singing songs, having a good time. Saul said it was the most fun he'd had since 1959. when we ran away from home to become astronauts. I haven't seen the old gang that much lately. Not sure why. I guess people just gotta go their own way.
The recent decline in interest rates has eased the pressure.
Pete's still on TV every night, still trying to save the world. Bobby and Linda have bought a bigger house, made a lot of new friends at the tennis club they belong to.
Congratulations.
Mickey became a born-again Christian. Turned his club into a family-style restaurant. Marty moved to L.A. Bought a big house in the hills. All his neighbors are rich and famous. He calls me all the time. He tells me I keep him sane.
Orlando, how you doing?
Eddie lucked out.
Thanks a lot.
Pork bellies opened at a record high that morning. He made millions. And married Sherry.
Good morning.
Car looks great, huh? How do you like this car, huh?
Most of all, I miss Saul. Of all the friends I've had in my life, I loved him the most. I thought that time would heal the loss, that the pain would subside. But that's not true. I miss Saul more and more every day. I guess some people aren't replaceable. As for Emily, well, she was married for a while. And she got divorced. She moved back to Chicago a few months ago, but we haven't talked to each other. People tell me that you can't recapture what you've lost, that when it's over, it's over. Maybe they're right. But whenever I'm out, I wonder, maybe I'll run into her. And if I did, what would I say?
I haven't read the newspaper in weeks. I don't know why. But this morning I felt like it, and there you were. I just happen to have three of you right here. A well-written book that explores the compromises that the generation of the 60s have made as they grew up.
Is that what it says?
Yeah.
That's not what it's about at all.
What's it about?
Oh.
Oh.
Did you see that?
See what?
Did you see the way the hat just pulled the roof?
Yeah.
The wind just blew the hat off my head.
Yeah, it's a windy day.
So, what's it about? It's about a guy who believed in happy endings.
Still believe in happy endings?
Absolutely.